common claim that you usually hear from climate change deniers is that in the 1970s, scientists used to believe that the Earth was headed towards a global cooling event and not a global warming event. Now, this pernicious claim has been recycled from anyone such as Penn Jillette of the show Bullshit to YouTubers like Computing Forever. But is it true? Is it true that a majority of climate scientists of the 1970s believed that the Earth was actually cooling and not warming? Or is this claim nothing more than a bunch of hot air? Let's take a look at an unexpected source when it comes to this claim of scientists believing in global cooling. It's actually not from a scientific institution at all, but rather from popular magazines such as Time magazine. This was even highlighted by Penn Jillette on the show Bullshit.
What the fuck are we gonna do? Listen to this. In Africa, drought continues for the sixth consecutive year. Record rains in parts of the US, Pakistan, and Japan caused some of the worst flooding in centuries. New England and Northern Europe have recently experienced the mildest winters within anyone's recollection. It says right here in Time magazine, the weather's gone nuts, and we humans are to blame. We have fucked up the environment, and now we're gonna pay for it. Scientists are telling us we're heading into a new ice age? What? It's from Time magazine, Monday, June 24th, 1974. Fuck.
Some noticeable examples of Time magazine spreading this idea to the public is in this excerpt from 1974. I cannot stress enough just how sensationalist the writing is in these articles. Telltale signs are everywhere, from the unexpected persistence and thickness of pack ice in the waters around Iceland to the southward migration of a warmth-loving creature like the armadillo from the Midwest. Since the 1940s, the mean global temperature has dropped about 2.7 Fahrenheit. Although that figure is at best an estimate, it is supported by other convincing data. When climatologist George J. Kukla of Columbia University's Lamont Doherty Geological Observatory and his wife Helena analyzed satellite weather data for Northern Hemisphere, they found that the area of the ice and snow cover had suddenly increased by 12% in 1971, and the increase has persisted ever since. Areas of Baffin Island in the Canadian Arctic, for example, were once totally free of any snow in summer. Now they are covered year-round. I also just love this illustration, which is, I don't know why, but it just makes me laugh. It's so exaggerated. I love it. Everything about this article is just so over the top. It's funny, to be honest. Another highlight of this article is this. Toronto climatologist Kenneth Hare, a former president of the Royal Meteorological Society, believes that the continuing drought and the recent failure of the Russian harvest gave the world a grim premonition of what might happen. I don't believe that the world's present population is sustainable if there are more than 3 years like 1972 in a row. Well, as you all can tell, we're still here, so that was a bunch of hogwash. We can also take a look at this article from 1975. And yeah, once again, I have to say, I really love these illustrations. They're just so over the top and unrealistic. Like, it's beyond parody, to be honest. It's just funny to me. There's a couple of problems with these articles and people pushing these articles as though it's a gotcha. One, it's not even true that at the time, 1974, that the global temperature had dropped by 2.7 Fahrenheit. It's just not true. We can look at a graph of the average temperature across the world and see it's clearly not true. And second of all, and this is the most important point, and this goes to Penn Jillette and other climate change deniers, Time magazine is not, has never been, and never will be a scientific journal. It's a popular magazine. Their primary function is to entertain you, maybe even give you some information about current situations in the world. But primarily, their job is not to give you a super detailed or even accurate scientific explanation of anything. These magazines do not have peer review. What you should look at are actual scientific journals at the time, as well as in current days. You know, journals that actually have a functioning peer review system. But you know what? Let's do it. Let's take a look at how many papers between 1965 to 1979 discussed cooling versus warming, or were simply neutral. But what do we actually see? Well, how about that? If you look at the number of published articles per year between 1965 to 1979, you find that there's a comfortable majority of papers arguing for a warming event or even a neutral event. In fact, you only have 7 papers in total between 1965 to 1979 arguing in favor of a cooling event. A whopping 44 papers projected warming. Even when it comes to papers that projected a neutral situation, they are less than half of the number of papers projecting warming. In other words, warming wins by far. So in other words, between this period of 1965 to 1979, you have 44 papers arguing in favor of warming, 19 papers arguing for a neutral event, and only 7 that argue for a cooling event. In other words, during this time period when you published an article, it was 7 times more likely to argue in favor of global warming rather than global cooling. And from this, it's clear as day that the claim that scientists used to push the idea of global cooling in the 1970s before they changed their mind and they started to push global warming instead is simply not true. This is a pernicious lie and it needs to stop. And whenever someone tries to argue this point, just send them this video. So that's the video, guys. Thank you for watching. I would appreciate it if you subscribed. Also remember to click the bell, otherwise you may not be notified. Please also follow me on social media, preferably Twitter, because that's where I post almost daily. Also, please consider supporting me on Patreon. Every dollar helps, to be honest. Anyway, thank you guys for watching, and I'll see you in the next one. Bye.
With it for a little while now. You want to get to the climate change thing, because you just read a book I wrote several years ago.
Yeah, yeah.
Which has an attack at someone who attacked me on climate change. Mm-hmm. I think that there's no way you can deny that there's climate change. I have completely changed on that. Although completely changed is a little bit confusing.
Yeah.
Because I never went beyond, I don't know.
Yeah.
What bothers me about the climate change thing was the great disservice done by Al Gore of exaggerating.
Yeah, no, it's always...
We have to scare people. We have to do this. And I hate the fact that style affected me, but the kind of people who were talking about it were the kind of people that were so dismissive of people that I loved that I...
You had an emotional reaction.
It was very, very emotional.